Welcome to the official QuickJack setup tutorial. In this video, we will show you how to get started with your new QuickJack portable car lift system. Before we begin, you will need the following tools and equipment to complete the setup: a set of hex keys and combination wrenches, an adjustable wrench, a Schrader valve tool, an air source such as a compressor or bike pump, 3 quarts of automatic transmission fluid or hydraulic oil, a funnel, and finally, a pair of safety glasses and gloves for protection. With sufficient space to lay out the components, we can get started. QuickJack comes in 3 numbered boxes. Check to make sure that you have a box 1, box 2, and box 3. Now begin by unboxing the contents of all 3 boxes and locating the manual. The latest version of the manual can also be found online at www.quickjack.com. In the manual, you will find complete setup, operation, and troubleshooting guides, as well as the parts list. It is important to verify that you have all the parts included in the kit before going any further. If you are missing any parts, please contact us immediately for assistance. We're going to show you how to set up the QuickJack by breaking it down into 5 simple parts: frames, hoses, power unit, bleeding procedure, and finally, testing. Let's get started. Part 1, the frames. Start by removing the shipping plug from the hydraulic cylinder. Next, install one of the cylinder elbow fittings from the assembly kit in its place. The cylinder elbow fitting should be installed with the O-ring end going into the hydraulic cylinder. When tightening the fitting, be sure to angle the other side of the fitting slightly upwards. For torque specs, please refer to the QuickJack manual. Now grab one of the short hoses from the assembly kit and connect the female end to the attached cylinder elbow fitting. Take one of the male quick connect fittings, along with thread seal tape, from the assembly kit. Apply thread seal tape to the threads at the end of the short hose, then attach the male fitting. The fitting should be good and snug, but be careful not to over-tighten. Finally, using a compressor or bike pump, fill the air cylinder to between 40 and 50 psi of air. Once filled, check for any air leaks. If air is coming back out of the air cylinder, tighten the valve core using a Schrader valve tool. If you are still experiencing a loss of air, please contact us for assistance. Repeat the same steps for the second frame. Once complete, move on to part 2, hoses. Part 2, the hoses. To prepare your long hoses, you'll need the 4 female quick disconnect fittings and thread seal tape from the assembly kit. First, wrap the thread seal tape around the threaded end of the hose 2 to 3 times. Then screw on the female quick connect fitting. Tighten the fitting until snug, but do not over-tighten. Repeat the same step on the other end and then on both ends of the second long hose. With the long hoses ready, we can set them aside with the frames and move on to part 3, the power unit. Part 3, the power unit. It is important to note that even though the power unit pictured may be different from your power unit, the setup procedure is the same. Refer to the manual for more information. First, grab the 2 power unit fittings from the assembly kit. On the power unit, you will find 2 shipping plugs. One at a time, remove the plugs and install the power unit fittings in their place. We recommend installing the lower fitting first, so that the top fitting is easier to install. Next, we'll fill the reservoir with automatic transmission fluid or hydraulic oil. To do this, remove the reservoir cap and set it aside. Using a funnel, pour in the fluid and fill until the fluid level sits roughly 1/2 inch below the fill hole. Lastly, replace the reservoir cap and hand tighten. If your power unit is equipped with a breather valve over the reservoir cap, be sure to loosen the valve before use. With the power unit set up and all components assembled, we can now bleed the hydraulic system. Part 4, bleeding the hydraulic system. To ensure proper function of your QuickJack, you must bleed the hydraulic system before lifting your vehicle. To do so, we will prepare the QuickJack for use by connecting the hoses at all quick connect fittings, making sure each long hose runs between a frame and the power unit, then plugging in the power unit to an appropriate power source. Next, we will prop the frames up by stacking 2 of the tall rubber blocks and 1 of the medium rubber blocks under the steel plate below the bleeder screw. They will elevate the bleeder screw, allowing the air to escape more efficiently. With everything connected, press the up button to start lifting the frames. The frames may rise erratically at first. This is perfectly normal. Continue lifting the frames to just under the first locking position. Then press the down button to lower the frames. They may lower slowly and at different speeds. This is normal without weight on the frames. Repeat this process 3 times to ensure the system is pressurized. Once the frames are lowered, we recommend placing a rag underneath the bleeder screw to catch any hydraulic fluid that comes out during the bleeding process. Then, using a hex key, slowly loosen the bleeder screw until you hear the air in the system released. Now, tighten the bleeder screw and press the up button on the controller for 1 to 2 seconds. Next, reopen the bleeder screw and press the up button again. Once hydraulic fluid is coming out without any air bubbles, immediately tighten the bleeder screw. Finally, press the down button 1 to 2 seconds and repeat the process for the opposite frame. Once complete, take the frames off the block so they lay flat on the ground and cycle the frames to just under the first locking position. The frame should be rising evenly at this point. If not, repeat the bleeding procedure until the frames are lifting evenly. With the bleeding procedure complete, you may now make your maiden lift with your vehicle. Part 5. Testing your QuickJack. It is important when operating your QuickJack for the first time to make sure both frames are positioned with the lock bars facing out. Next, check that the short hoses are correctly routed underneath the frames. When bringing in your vehicle, remember that the hoses should never be driven over. Also, make sure you have enough clearance around your vehicle to account for radial shift when lifting. For more information on radial shift, please refer to your manual. Position the frames to line up with your vehicle's factory recommended lift points. Keep in mind, QuickJack frames must be parallel to each other at all times. Next, place the rubber lift blocks best suited to your vehicle in the lift trays. With the frames and blocks lined up, press the up button on the power unit's remote pendant control. Continue holding the up button until the rubber blocks are just making contact with your vehicle's lift points, and verify that all four corners are correctly engaging your vehicle. Once verified, press the down button and allow both frames to descend an inch or two below the lift points. Finally, press the up button again to begin lifting your vehicle. With your vehicle lifting evenly, raise the QuickJack to the first locking position. To engage the lock, lift until the release cam is just over the lock. Then press down to lower the frames and the lock bar will rest firmly on the lock. Continue to hold the down button for 5 seconds or so to depressurize the system. Now you can check for any leaks. With the hoses depressurized and your QuickJack engaged on its locks, it is safe to disconnect the long hoses at the quick connect fittings. Now is a good time to tighten any loose fittings and reapply thread seal tape if needed. If everything appears to be working normally, you're ready to fully operate QuickJack. To lower, press up for a second or two so that the lock bar is disengaged from the lock blocks. Flip the silver release cam by lifting the lock and setting it back into the lock bar channel. Press and hold the down button to lower the vehicle to the ground, and again, depressurize. Like so many enthusiasts around the world, we hope you enjoy your QuickJack for many years to come. If this video was helpful, press like, subscribe to our channel, and don't hesitate to let us know how we're doing in the comments below. Our channel is filled with helpful tips, troubleshooting advice, and updates that help you get the most out of your QuickJack. If you want to share your car projects with the world, find us on Facebook or Instagram with hashtag QuickJack. From all of us at QuickJack, happy lifting!